So a really important question is voltage, and what's the top voltage and what's your low voltage cutout? Oh, all right, continuing on. So I want to do a video about voltage. Well, multitasking around here. So when you have a 72 volt system, your bike will charge to 84 volts, sometimes a little higher, like 82 to 88 sometimes, but let's call it 84. That's not a percentage. A low voltage cutoff on a 72 volt bike is around 65. So your voltage is going to start at 84, and as you ride, once you get into the 70s, you want to think about charging and definitely buy 65 volts. The same system applies to a 60 volt system and an 84 volt system. So you've got an 84 volt bike, it'll charge to 96 volts. You want to start charging at around 77 is the low cutoff. It's different on different bikes because they're set up that way in the controller. Right, Darren? Jolene from Ride the Wind, and we're answering, have some questions answers by Darren, the marvelous tech.
So if your bike's 72 volts, your charge is going to charge that. That's 72 volts nominal. So it operates above that and below that. So your charge is going to charge it. If it's a lithium, your charge will charge to 84 volts. It's not a percentage, it's an algorithm. So you can try and figure it out if you want. But lead acid will charge more. If you got a 72 volt lead acid bike, your charger will probably charge that to 85, maybe 85 and a bit, sometimes even 86.
88.
So the 88.
Yeah,
So
the 72 volt 45 amp hour from Emo is an output of 88.
okay, so that's why you can use a lithium charger on a lead acid battery because it won't overcharge it. But if you do it the other way around, you are going to cook your lithium battery.
Yeah, just don't use a different charger, but that is
Yeah,
that's a
in a
it
pinch,
in a
but yeah.
pinch. Thanks for watching.